Okay, now that we have linked the dynamic components with the HTML template, now it's time to start accessing the data that we want to show. Okay, there's a listing here of job positions. So the goal now is, how can you access data that you have stored somewhere? Okay. Well, for this project, what we are going to do is to feed it with a JSON file. I'm going to copy the link that I have here. Here, so you can see it. We paste it here. Okay, this is a JSON file, and this is a record inside that JSON file. Okay, from here. Okay, so the goal is to use this URL in order to get that information and process it properly and show it on the template. Okay, so in this video, the first thing is to access the data, and for that we need to use a connection component. Okay, this client connection component, to paste it here. As you can see, it's a non-visual component. It just provides functionality, nothing visual. We need to name these to jobs. Okay, and I'm going to paste the URL for the JSON inside the URI property. Okay. Then if I set the active property to true, then I'm already connected, but I can't see anything because I'm not connecting any control to it. In order to do that, I need first to use a dataset, client dataset. I'm going to name this component as a CVS jobs, and I'm going to set it to this connection. Okay. But again, this is another non-visual component, so I can't see anything. In order to link it with components, I need a data source, and I won't use it later. This is for you just to see the data and how it can be accessed. I'm going to link this data source to this data set. Okay, and then I'm going to place a DB grid here. And then link this DB grid to that data source. Okay, this is my data. Okay, these are all the fields that I'm reading from the JSON, and here are all the fields that I can use. Okay, I'm not going to use this because what I need to do is to put this information in this format, because this is what it comes from the template. Okay, I will show that on the next video. Thank you.